Right. Hello, 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 and welcome to Never Mind the Buzzcocks. And if you're new to the show, I'm the new host, Rhod Gilbert. Deal with it. I have.
When you look at my face, you think babysitter.
And I look at your face, I think first person to get killed in a horror film.
Look at this team, though. Look at the three of us. I feel normal for once. We look like the extras in a heroin den.
Let's make it harder for Bobby. Let's blindfold him with the envelope.
Okay.
Okay, ready?
All right.
If I get put in the trunk of a car, I'm gonna be sad. Oh, wait! Man, this looks like a school production of The Wizard of Oz.
Is a fan of yours. If you get it right, one of your biggest fans ever is going to get the night of his life. So if you get it wrong, you're going to disappoint a fan and probably get the shit kicked out of you by somebody who doesn't even know who you are.
National television, you know?
One is definitely not my fan. One is
You get out there, Steve. Let the force be with you.
Who is beckoning you with his eyes?
Hallelujah!
Okay.
One.
Three.
Three.
Oh, you.
Over here, we kick like this. Of course it was hard. It's supposed to just rub it in like that over here.
It was all right.
That's the best.
Right, all good fun, unfortunately.
He's got to go to the hospital.
Of course, it was Keith Richards. Bonus point, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh.
Both teams.
Oh, right.
Do we buzz or just...
No, you don't buzz because you haven't got anything to buzz with.
We've done the button there. I'm quite enjoying it.
All right, yeah, fingers on buzzers.
Yeah.
There's no sound comes out, but I'll try and look.
I can imagine Milliken knocking out erotic fiction.
Can you?
Oh, and then he held them... His big meaty hands. Oh, he took me out for a supper.
You're right, that all of my eroticism is all based on food, you're right.
Every word in Geordie sounds pretty funny.
Pulsating. Pulsating and throbbing. And then he took me out for a curry. And these big hands like walls, oh, bangers. Sausage fingered loving.
Can I make a suggestion?
Baseball mitts. What would you like, Rhod? Would you like this to touch you? But I'm no. Hands.
Can I make a
okay. Ladies and gentlemen, Kenny Rogers and Alice Cooper.
Islands in the street, that is what we are.
God, when I was on tour with the Boosh, the driver of our bus said, I'm Marilyn Manson, been in his bus and he had Prince in his bun. He was a Geordie, and I said, what was Prince like? And he went, he's a right clumsy little fucker. He said one time he was filling up the tour bus, the water tank, with a hose at the petrol garage, and Prince got out and tripped over it. And then got stuck in the door at the petrol garage.
Each of you has been given an item of clothing that corresponds to a particular musical artiste. All you have to do is pop it on and work out who the Blazing Squad you are. Frisk underneath your desk area and see what you can come up with. And pop it on, please, now. Hello?
I've got a lovely bunch of coconuts. There's a clue.
Blimey, you do wear those, well, Lloyd. What are you thinking?
Well, I'm Katy Perry.
Oh, Lloyd, that's really ruined the prospect of some great television that you've just blurted out.
Yeah, Lloyd. I'll tell you now, you are right with Katy Perry. Oh, do you know what? I was making a cake this afternoon and I did forget to cream it, so that's perfect, actually.
Like, oh, that's fantastic.
Can we just,
Yeah, let's have a go.
If you could just,
There you go.
If you could just de-breast yourself.
Yeah? Is that enough?
Oh, God. When I thought I'll do it, it'll be quite funny, but it's actually offensive. What are you thinking, no?
I'm thinking...
Focus on your thinking.
Michael.
It could be Michael.
Is that how he sounds? I can't remember how he speaks. He does speak like that, doesn't he?
Gee, Pluto! There, maybe I can hang out of the window.
Can you just stand up and hold me and pretend I'm a baby and we'll see if it works?
Out the window.
Yeah, out the window.
He did this, didn't he, with the baby? He went, this is hilarious, but there's people out there. I didn't do that. I did not do that in any way.
Do you know, I follow Blanket Jackson on Twitter.
Who? Blanket?
Blanket Jackson.
Who's Blanket?
He's a real boy and he's grown up.
He's the son.
Yeah, this one.
He's called Blanket.
Blanket.
Why did he call him Blanket? Did he ever justify it?
He did. He said that the baby was really comforting and cuddly and cozy like a blanket.
Oh, I bet he did.
Hey, come on now.
So you do a bit of voiceover work, don't you?
Yeah, I've been known to.
You do a good Peter Dixon.
It's time to face the music.
Like that kind of thing. Good.
Who's Peter Dixon?
He's a voiceover man.
Okay.
He sounds a bit like this.
Ah!
He's on The X Factor.
Have you been on it?
No.
You should give it a go. You're quite talented. I think you do well, you know. I can see Louis Walsh really bringing the best out of you.
I love the mushrooms on the floor. I loved it. You're like a young Tina Turner.
What impression can Lisa Stansfield do? Hurry.
Hello, my name is Jane Horrocks, and I'm a professional northerner.
That's the same as your own voice.
Joe doesn't like other people doing impressions.
Get off my turf!
Ooh, big track, big track, big track!
Bucket on your head!
I have a serious mental health problem.
Bucket dust.
No, it's not bucket dust. No!
Bucket
dust. Big track! Don't let me sit like this. Come on! It's ridiculous.
Mr. Sandman!
You look good like that.
We're going to keep going until somebody gets this, because I am not ruining all my clothes for nothing.
Suntan by the Sands of Barbados. Oh, Sex on the Beach.
Sex on the Beach? How much sex do you have to have on a beach? Think of the a prison in Paris. Come on.
Bastille.
Bastille, yes. Oh. That's the band, Bastille.
It was really worth the prop, though, Rob. I think it went really well.
It's Pompeii.
Never heard of it.
Never heard of it.
I still don't even get it.
It's Bastille. Pompeii is a big hit.
What's that got to do with you pouring dust on yourself?
It's volcanic ash.
Oh.
What's
it got to do with a bucket?
Well, no, the bucket was just to hold the ash.
You kept saying bucket, bucket.
I never said bucket. What's it? I had to have some. We found out today, we did a little bit of research, and in all your appearances on the show over the years, you're one of the lowest scoring contestants of all time.
I don't know anything about pop music.
Absolutely nothing.
Well, I've heard of certain things, like Duran?
Fuse, it's been a big year for you, hasn't it?
It's been an amazing year, yeah.
Top 10 singles galore.
Crazy. I had a song called Azonto. Azonto's it's a dance that's major in Africa. Paul, you should try it.
There's nothing I would like more on this planet than to see Paul Foot dance into Azonto.
Yeah, the Azonto, the traditional Ghanaian dance.
Traditional Ghanaian. Yes, you know the traditional Ghanaian dance.
Oh, yeah.
Wow.
Will you still be able to see your auto cue for your humour?
Do you need the music? Is it better with or without the music, Fuse?
Let's go. Well, you'll actually get stoned in Ghana for doing that. Sorry.
Can you teach me the more traditional methods?
Yes.
Let me save your life.
Are you ready? Are you ready?
Oh.
This is like the weirdest episode of Strictly Come Dancing ever.
So it's all in the feet.
All in the feet?
Yes. You've got to twist your foot like that. That's it. So what you're going to do, make a fist.
Make a fist?
Yes. OK, that's good, that's good. That's good.
Not that kind of
bring
fist,
it to the middle. Bring it here. And then to the sky. There you go.
Wonderful cultural exchange of ideas there, Paul Foot and Fuse, ladies and gentlemen. That was three of a kind with Baby Cakes, but which of our lineup is Nikki Gallant? What if I tell you Nikki is a party planner now?
Party planner.
If I give you some party things, why don't you see if you can sniff out?
Go on, Fred Bassett. Do
Nikki.
Go about your foul business.
So he's a party planner.
He's a party planner now.
So I will go over.
Sniff him out, Paul. Sniff out our party planner.
Right. Put my party.
Up away.
So, I will stand with him and I'll see, does it feel like a party? Or, as he is a party planner, is there a sense of the anticipation of a party to come? it doesn't feel like a party. Now the second one.
You get a party vibe, Paul?
It's quite a sexual vibe. But I don't think it's helping much. I'm a drunk uncle at a party. Let's see how they react. Professional party planner would cope with it. Yeah. My wife left me. Yeah, mate. Women, they've always let me down. Oh, they hit with women. Yeah, I slept.
Okay, Paul, you've had a lot of chances. I've got some facts about you all. I read somewhere that you have a party before a gig. I didn't quite get to the bottom of that when I read that.
We met at a party. It was such a good party. I had to ask you where we were.
No, that is not a reflection on the party. I heard about this party. You've got a party trick where you play the guitar around the back of your head.
It's like the worst thing that you can do is be that guy at the party who gets the acoustic guitar
out. It's terrible. Terrible, that. Come on. Can you really play it behind your head?
Yeah, I know.
Whoa, 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 it's happening, it's happening.
Deal with that.
Wow. Ladies and gentlemen, I'll give you a point. Watch this. My bongos, you know?
Where is this going?
Where isn't it going?
I'll tell you where it's going. You watch this. Hands a bit low, though. Hands a bit lower. Enough of that. Phil seem have nothing, and Noel seem have one. Stacey, can I just interrupt this?
Yep.
Do you know what's happening?
I do. I was concentrating here.
That's good.
And then I thought, if I can look this way, I might be able to lip read them talking about what they think it is.
That is a very good strategy.
I'm short-sighted, so it didn't work.
So let me just check this out. Your ears don't work and you're short-sighted.
No, I'm a mute.
Stacey, do you want a clue?
Yes, please.
It's big and red and hangs out by the river.
It?
It.
You know that clown who's always in the drains?
He's always in the drains!
Wow!
I hate you all!
Oh, It! The film, Stephen
King! Yes.
Let's just see if you're right. Is it It by Stephen King?
That was a really bad clue then.
It wasn't a really bad clue, it was a really bad answer.
You know, it's quite weird. I was going to wear this dress, obviously, with a scary
dress?
Clown's face on it.
A dress?
Again, the scary clown face was the important bit of that. You honed in on dress.
You're going to wear a dress?
With a clown's face on it, it looked like that clown.
You've already got long hair and you're going to wear a dress.
Still not getting the... What I'm saying is...
You are it. I'm just terrified.
Are you? It is a bit frightening, isn't it?
It's creepy.
The most frightening thing is the nose and the place it's positioned.
I feel like I should be able to do that thing where it goes...
That was Five Star with Systematic. For which of our lineup is band member Stedman Pearson?
I know it's not number four because I went to school with him.
No, seriously.
Yeah. We used to get on the 94 bus to school, do you remember, and talk about wrestling.
Don't nod, don't nod.
What do you have on your rider?
I would have like. Fresh ginger slices.
Fresh ginger slices.
Stuff like that. Yeah, nice. For the
voice. Really, really hate Jerry Halliwell.
I've never seen a fresh ginger slice. What's it like, Nicole?
It's just a ginger root, and it's just sliced.
It's just a ginger root slice. You make it sound so simple.
Yeah, that's all it is. I don't understand how you've gone through life and never seen a slice of ginger. You've seen Ginger Rod. Don't play this, I'm from Wales, I don't know anything.
I didn't say anything about being from Wales, you fucking racist.
I've never seen ginger, I've never seen ginger. You can get it anywhere.
Can you?
Any shop.
Halfords.
Last time I bought ginger, there was a root that looked a bit like a hand. And so for most of the shopping trip, I spent just putting it as my hand. Ginger hand?
Unbelievable. believe that.
And then when I paid for it, and then when I was packing it up, and then when I went to get my change off of the lady, I went like that. And she slowly put the money and it fell through. And we both shared a little ginger hand moment. And I went home and I did not touch myself with it.
I'm going to ask you this once, though. Did you touch yourself with it?
I had a ginger wank.
Yeah. With this ball bongo man. Anybody got an idea where we are in the show? I've completely lost it. Oh, you were on next. Oh!
Can't believe you used my face as a visual reminder. You went, oh yeah, I know.
I often use your face to navigate through the show. I've got pictures of you on my fridge. Sometimes I look at you and I go, oh, it's Ben's day. That was Wayne Wonder with No Letting Go, but which of our lineup is Wayne himself? Is it... Have I got to say something funny about him? What's he got in his arms? It's not number one.
I kind of want to touch his arms.
Go on, touch him.
Just out of,
go and touch his arms.
Ask him nicely for... Oh!
Rob, apparently he's got legs like shrubs.
What's shrubs in Welsh?
We don't have shrubs. This is the first time live on TV you're going to see somebody pop a sweatband. It's going to go. Stand back, everyone. The sweatband's going to blow. This has been Never Mind the Buzzcocks. I've been Rhod Gilbert. Good night.
Good night.
Good night.